How's it going, everybody, and welcome back to another episode of the Pokemon White 2 postgame. Now, this episode is going to be working a little bit differently compared to the rest, because our focus is not actually going to be inside the main game, but rather on a spin-off title that connects to the main game. So, with that in mind, let's hop inside of Pokemon Dream Radar, or Pokemon AR Searcher in Japan, which is a spin-off title that was released on the 3DS the same day that Black 2 and White 2 were in each respective region. So, in the Pokemon Dream Radar, you are the assistant to Professor Burnett. And for those who didn't play this spin-off title and connect it to Black 2 and White 2, you may recognize Professor Burnett as appearing in the Sun and Moon and Ultra Sun and Moon games of Generation 7. Her first appearance was in a spin-off title, so in case you didn't know, now you do. Anyway, you are Professor Burnett's assistant, and she needs help collecting data in the Interdream Zone, which is a big, it's kind of like the Dimensional Research Lab, except a little bit downgraded. So, in the Interdream Zone field study, you basically need to use Dream Cloud data, which turns into Dream Orbs, and you need to advance research. Burnett does all the research stuff, you just collect all the orbs. So, there are different things when it comes to the Dream Clouds and Dream Orbs. Color clouds. So, for example, as you'll be seeing, as I hop into the gameplay, you will be seeing pink color clouds. Now, pink isn't the only color, but it's only the default color for now. So, color clouds will contain Dream Orbs, always and forever. And there are other clouds, stormy clouds, that are highlighted yellow, and they turn gray, so stormy, that's where they get their name from. Now, stormy clouds are pretty cool in the fact that not only that can they contain Dream Orbs that you can collect, but sometimes stormy clouds will contain Pokemon in glow spheres. Now, these Pokemon have their hidden ability, always, and when transferred, they are in a Dream Ball. So, pretty much what the gist of this is, I mean, it has Dream in the name, you can probably figure this out. I think the Dream World was still open when Dream Radar came out. I may be wrong about that, but basically this is the next step in terms of the whole hidden ability Dream project thing. So this kind of replaced the Dream World, but this has a bigger purpose than just what the Dream World was. I'll talk about that a little bit later, because this might end up being like a two-part video, because I really underestimated the whole Dream Radar connectivity, and there's a lot of stuff I need to do in the Dream Radar before what I want to do happens, so yeah. Anyway, I'm just going to talk about brief things about the Dream Radar for now, and where was I? Oh yeah, Pokemon will have their hidden ability, they're transferred over in a Dream Ball. Pretty cool. So, the Pokemon levels depend on the amount of badges that you've obtained in the main game. So, for example, if you just started out Black 2 or White 2, and you've also been playing Pokemon Dream Radar, and you catch a Pokemon, they will be at level 5. If you have 1 to 2 badges, the Pokemon will be level 10. If you have 3 to 4 badges, the Pokemon will be level 20. If you have 5 to 6 badges, the Pokemon will be level 30, and if you have 7 to 8, or all, gym badges, the Pokemon will be level 40. Now, there's actually a lot of Pokemon you can catch in the Dream Radar, but I'm only gonna go over the first couple, the first handful, because, again, if I mention other things related to the Pokemon that you can find, it kind of spoils things of what this is about, although, if I'm correct, by the way, this is post-commentary, so you might be able to tell why is he talking ahead of the gameplay or behind the gameplay. This is post-commentary, because the whole aspect of basically recording the footage, I have to stand away from my computer with the 3DS and swirl all around my room. Basically, is how that works. Anyway, enough rambling. So, the Pokemon you can find inside of pink orbs, they're more likely to appear in pink orbs, I think only in pink orbs, maybe more, I don't know, it's worded differently on Bulbapedia. But in pink orbs, the Pokemon that you can find are Drifloon, Muna, Riolu, Sigilyph, and Swablu. Now, Glowspheres don't always contain Pokemon, they always contain Pokemon, but rather they always don't result in capturing the Pokemon. Sometimes, instead of catching a Pokemon, whatever Pokemon it was, you won't know what it is, but the Pokemon will sometimes drop an item instead. And again, I would go over every single item you can find, but I would be spoiling things for what's to come, even though you clearly saw that if you know legendary Pokemon in Black and White, or 5th Gen in general, we will basically be capturing different forms of the forces of nature, Thundurus, Tornadus, and Landorus. And these forms are really cool, so I really want to talk about them, but I don't want to spoil it, really, and go over them yet. Although, spoiler alert, maybe not, depending on the gameplay, how far behind or ahead I am. We will see one of them pop up after we do a bit of research. Anyway, enough about that. So, Glowspheres don't always result in Pokemon capture. Sometimes they drop items instead. And something else I want to mention, and I actually did not know about this until I started doing research for the Dream Radar. You can actually find Pokemon. You can, go immediately to, a capture situation scenario using a button combination by starting up your research. Now, if you press start up right down left XRL, you can find Beldum. If you press start RLYX left right YX, then you can find Hoot Hoot. And if you press start up down right left YRL, then you can find Slowpoke. Again, I didn't know that these button combo Pokemon existed, so it's really, really cool that they actually have more than just the usual amount of Pokemon. But anyway, so all of that aside, the orbs that you collect, the dream orbs you collect from the dream clouds, not only can you advance research with Burnett and unlock different pathways to advance your research to catch these other forms of Tornadus, Thundurus, and Landorus eventually, not right away, not all of them at least, then you can also use these orbs to upgrade your gear. And yeah, so it's really, really cool. The Dream Radar is, kind of underrated. I kind of underrated it, to be honest. But the Dream Radar is actually really neat. Oh, and I guess since I've been spoiling things a little bit, after you've caught the new Landorus form, which is very far away, so don't expect that anytime soon. I'm probably going to take a break from the Dream Radar to do other stuff while I record the footage for that. After you, eventually, far, far away in the future, after catching the new Landorus form, if you insert a game cartridge while playing Dream Radar of Diamond, Pearl, Platinum, Heart Gold, or Soul Silver, you can catch the box legendary representing each game. So with Diamond in the cartridge, you can get Dialga. With Pearl in the cartridge, you can get Palkia. Why am I saying in the cartridge? The game is in a cartridge. In the game slot, there we go. With Platinum in the game slot, you can get Giratina. With Heart Gold in the game slot, you can get Ho-Oh. And with Soul Silver in the game slot, you can get Lugia. Again, that's actually really far off, so if you want these in Black and White or Black 2 White 2, it's only Black and White 2 because Dream Radar isn't eligible because of the different forms of the forces of nature. Anyway, so that's that on the Dream Radar. Now, once you are done with doing all of your field research, you can transfer the Pokemon, or items if you've got them, that you obtained in the Dream Radar using the Nintendo 3DS Link under Unova Link in the main game on the main menu. And as you probably have seen by now, this is the movesets of the different Pokemon that I caught throughout my first adventures through the Pokemon Dream Radar. I managed to catch a Muna, a Riolu, and a Sigilyph. And another Muna, but, I mean, it's the same moveset. There's nothing different except the nature. So, with that, that is going to do it for this episode of the Pokemon White 2 postgame. There's gonna be another video about the Dream Radar a little bit later on, but it's not exactly going to be focused on the Dream Radar. The Dream Radar portion will kind of just be there. Anyways, once again, that's gonna do it for me, so thank you for watching, and next time on the White 2 postgame, again, I don't really know what I'm gonna be doing because I didn't have my notes up. Guess I had all my notes up for the Dream Radar that I wrote down. Nonetheless, thank you for watching, and until next time, catch you later.